Really, in any situation where a patient fails their first anti-epileptic medication, perampanel or Fycompa would be an appropriate choice of medication to use for a variety of different reasons. Number one, the efficacy, as shown by both the FREEDOM study and the FAME study, the efficacy of Fycompa being used early on is really quite good. In the FAME study, the seizure-free rates were close to 50%. I think it was like 47% of patients became seizure-free in that study. Perampanel has a very long half-life, so if there's a concern where patients might be having seizures because of missing their medication, this just becomes a very easy choice under those circumstances. The results you would expect, from adding a medication on to somebody who's failed a prior medication, based on the data from the Kwan and Brody study, which was published in the New England Journal of Medicine in the early 2000s, the chance of that person becoming seizure-free were only 13% if they failed the first medication and the second medication was added. Based on the results of the FAME study, even though these are obviously different patient populations, different methodologies for studying these patients, in the FAME study, when perampanel was added to first monotherapy failure, the chance of becoming seizure-free were really quite high, was just under 50%, close to 47%. So at least the data that we have available shows us that perampanel, when used early, can be really quite effective. So obviously, if somebody has failed monotherapy, the medication choices that we have would really the medication that we would tend to use first would be drugs that have a long half-life, that we can get up to effective doses in a relatively short period of time. Perampanel, for instance, has a very long half-life of around 105 hours. So we typically titrate the dose up every 2 to 3 weeks. Based on the results of the FAME study, the majority of the patients in that study were on 4 milligrams a day. So either 4 milligrams or 6 milligrams, but the majority of them were on 4 milligrams. So we can reach effective doses of Fycompa really within 2 weeks of initiating treatment. Yeah, so the trial design essentially was where, we added the investigators added Fycompa to a first monotherapy failure. These were patients who were either on enzyme inducers or non-enzyme inducers, both categories of medications. And Fycompa was added and then titrated up. And then they basically looked at the data and said, okay, what are the most common doses, that are being used in these patients to achieve seizure freedom or to achieve a good reduction in seizures. And really the vast majority of patients went on 4 milligrams a day, followed by 6 milligrams a day, and good efficacy was seen at both of those doses. Most common side effects, obviously, that were seen with Fycompa are what we expect, from having used it before, things like somnolence, dizziness. I think the overall risk of one of the things that was seen both in the FREEDOM and in the FAME study actually was that there were no patients that had homicidal ideation. The risk of psychiatric side effects was very low. So I think all this information should really give people quite a bit of assurance that, when used at those doses, that it's a safe medication to use.